Boa tarde, Visão Plural, edição do dia 12 de junho de 2015, o chamado Dia do Comerciante, que transformou-se em Dia dos Namorados. Bem, primeiro devemos dar uma satisfação aos nossos internautas. Nós divulgamos que hoje faríamos uma entrevista com peritos criminais. E é verdade. Acontece que no Brasil existem várias qualidades de assessoria de imprensa. Porque até no Brasil, até pipoqueiro tem assessor de imprensa. Acontece que, ao chegar na televisão hoje, eu descobri que as pessoas que eu iria entrevistar às 5 horas da tarde estavam no programa de 1 hora da tarde, do Gente que Fala, no rádio e na televisão. Não era justo com os espectadores, com os nossos internautas, entrevistá-los novamente agora. Então, vamos fazer um programa especial em homenagem a um ator importantíssimo que faleceu na sexta-feira passada, mas a morte foi só anunciada ontem pela família, o ator Christopher Lee, um inglês que fez 300 filmes na sua carreira, que se iniciou em 1958 com O Vampiro da Noite. Talvez você não esteja lembrando quem é Christopher Lee, ou você lembra de Star Wars, Jornada das Estrelas, lembre do filme de James Bond e lembre também do filme que ele fez baseado no vampiro. Mas nós vamos mostrar a vocês que esse grande ator, ator que sempre interpretou personagens maus, era não só um grande ator, como um ser humano da melhor qualidade. Tanto que ele teve um programa especial da TV inglesa, da BBC inglesa, Esta é Sua Vida, em que ele recebia os seus colegas de filmagem e rememorava alguns trechos de filmes. Vamos começar com um pequeno trecho em que vocês vão notar as várias mudanças que o Christopher Lee sofreu através dos tempos. É uma coisa curta, mas que mostra as várias facetas de um grande ator. Vamos lá.
Thank you.
lembraram? Esse foi o grande ator Christopher Lee. A família decidiu, ele morreu no domingo, a família decidiu só anunciar anteontem. Então, ele morreu em Londres, ele nasceu em 1922, eu estou lendo como faz o William Bonner. Foi Vampiro da Noite em 58 que ele iniciou a sua vida de ator. E nesse filme ele foi o Conde Drácula e ele contracenou com seu grande amigo Peter Cushing, que juntamente com Vincent Price formou o trio que fez filmes de terror a vida inteira. Peter Cushing morreu em 1994. Bem, ele voltaria ao papel de Drácula em outros filmes: Drácula, o Vampiro do Sexo, em 1963, Drácula, o Príncipe das Trevas, em 1966, e também Drácula, o Perfil do Diabo, em 1968, o Drácula, Pai e Filho, em 1976. Em entrevista ao jornal inglês The Telegraph, em 1911, ele disse que estava cansado de ser lembrado apenas por esses filmes. E dizia: "Por favor, me descreva como uma lenda do terror. Já passei dessa fase." Na década de 70, se tornou um dos vilões preferidos do filme 007 contra o Homem com a Pistola de Ouro, interpretando o Homem de Palha, que era o que contracenava contra o James Bond nessa versão de Roger Corman. Depois ele passou, conquistou em vários papéis. No episódio 2, O Ataque dos Clones do Star Wars, ele também, e depois Star Wars, episódio 3, A Vingança do Sith. Ele era Saruman na franquia dos Senhores dos Anéis. Ele recebeu a distinção de Sir pela coroa britânica e sempre disse que não gostava de viver ocioso. Por isso ele fez 300 filmes e adquiriu várias faces que vocês viram que mudavam com muita facilidade. Vamos lembrar um dos filmes de vampiro, só para você saber como era a interpretação desse grande ator que nos apareceu aos 93 anos. Agora vamos ver um vampiro. Esse foi Drácula, o Vampiro do Sexo. Nesse filme também aparece o Peter Cushing, que é outro ator inglês especialista em filmes de terror. Era Peter Cushing, Christopher Lee e Vincent Price. Bem, agora ele tinha uma preferência especial pelo gênero musical de heavy metal e tinha uma voz muito boa. E com os 92 anos, ele gravou com uma banda italiana, Rhapsody of Fire. Ele gravou um clipe e um LP. E vocês vão ter o privilégio agora, às 16 horas e 36 minutos, de assistir a atuação de Christopher Lee, cantor, com essa banda italiana, Rhapsody of Fire. É uma interpretação magnífica e demonstra a inquietude de um ator de nível shakespeariano que não recusava papéis, estava sempre atuando e por isso acabou sendo distinguido com a ordem de Sir, que é o máximo na Inglaterra para pessoas que são do nível plebeu. Vamos lá então com a atuação do ator e cantor Christopher Lee.
Yeah. What has been will be again. What has been done will be done again. There is nothing new under the sun.
Gostaram? Christoph Lee fez essa excursão musical quando tinha 92 anos. Uma idade que muita gente recusa trabalho, muita gente fica em casa olhando para o céu e talvez inútil. Esse homem e teve a ousadia de gravar My Way, o grande sucesso de Frank Sinatra, com a influência do heavy metal. Vamos fazer um pequeno intervalo desse programa que vocês devem e eu, a assessoria de imprensa, que cometeu ato falho. E nós, na volta, vamos mostrar outros clipes, outras facetas desse grande ator, Christoph Lee. Voltamos já com Visão Plural. Eu sou o jornalista Patrício Bentes, que apresento às sextas-feiras, às 16 horas, o programa Visão Plural. Um programa que não aborda assuntos que todas as televisões falam. Nós fugimos da mesmice. Você pode nos assistir só aqui, na TV da internet.
As nossas recordações são os nossos maiores tesouros. Carregamos durante toda a nossa vida. Manipular, distorcer ou implantar falsas memórias, além de ser uma violência, é crime. Somos responsáveis por esse tesouro. Não promova alienação parental.
Sim, meus amigos, muito prazer, sou Sérgio Oliveira e estou aqui para lembrar vocês que toda segunda-feira, 9 horas da noite, eu estou aqui na TV da internet com o Futebol Alternativo TV. Sim, Série D, Série C, Copas Estaduais, as discussões de acesso, tudo aquilo que nenhum outro programa esportivo fala, tem a coragem, a capacidade de falar, nós falamos aqui na TV. Toda segunda, 9 horas da noite, só aqui na TV da internet.
Tem a ver com alguma coisa.
De onde vem a água que a gente bebe?
Da torneira.
Ih, nada a ver. Vem dos rios que nascem da mata.
Sabia que a gente só respira por causa das árvores?
A árvore respira?
Respira. A árvore respira.
E o que, que você tem a ver com isso?
Meu ar.
Minha água.
Minha árvore.
Meu ambiente.
Mata Atlântica.
SOS Mata Atlântica. Mais 25 anos.
Você já ouviu falar na lei de zoneamento? Ela está em discussão na Câmara de Vereadores e existe para planejar melhor a nossa cidade. Definindo como vai ficar a sua rua, o seu quarteirão, o seu bairro, dizendo onde pode ter comércio, moradia, emprego ou áreas verdes. Quer saber mais? Acesse o nosso portal. Participe, uma cidade melhor também passa pelas suas mãos.
Yeah!
homenageando o grande ator inglês Christopher Lee, que faleceu no domingo passado, dia 7, mas que a divulgação da morte foi feita ontem, a pedido da sua família, através do portal do jornal Telegraph, de Londres. Bem, ele morreu de morte natural, mas ele deixa uma faceta imorredora de fãs que sabem da sua qualidade artística e da sua capacidade. Mas como no mundo nada se cria, tudo se transforma, lembra daquele programa Esta é Sua Vida, que tinha na televisão brasileira, televisão aberta brasileira? Ele começou na TV inglesa e chamava-se This Life. E Christopher Lee teve uma homenagem num programa dessa ordem, em que ele recebeu diversos artistas que contracenaram com ele em outros filmes. Nesse documentário, vamos chamar assim, um programa especial sobre a vida do grande ator, tiveram presentes Peter Cushing, Vincent Price e Olive Reid. É um programa em inglês, mas que mostra o encontro do ator e dos personagens e dos atores que contracenaram com eles em todos os filmes que ele fez durante a sua carreira. Claro que o documentário é da década de 70. Depois disso, ele fez muita coisa. Vamos ver This Life.
This is your life, and that's a fight I've got to stop in the next few seconds. Not so much to catch my man alive, but at the point where fiction becomes fact. Now, one of the fences on that film set down there is top fight director William Hobbs, who's worked on some of the most famous films, television, and theater productions the world over. The other man he's fencing with is a world-famous actor himself, no mean swordsman either. A man who's provided many a spine-chilling moment in the cinema. But it's very, very important that I go through the right door on that set at the right moment when he's pinned there for a matter of seconds. So here goes. Gentlemen, put aside your weapons. Timely rescue, Christopher, because tonight, this is your life.
That is a conspiracy. An outrageous conspiracy. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, hey, well enough, oh. Christian, I think, that door.
Oh, I enjoyed that song.
Well, I came out of it alive. I'm beginning to wonder if I also got.
First of all, my thanks to my fellow conspirator, Bill Hobbs. He told me it was just a workout, but it looked a pretty tough fight to me.
Well, if I'd known how it was going to end, it would have ended differently when we did it, I can promise you. Very differently.
I tell you, I was a bit nervous coming through that door anyway.
Well, Eamon, in my professional life, I've opened a few doors, I've been behind a few, but I think the joke's on me this time, isn't it?
Well, it's not a joke. It's a very great story, and it is your story, Christopher Lee, your life. And you've just received an accolade that's always a high point for stars of the film business, a presentation to royalty at a royal premiere. Your latest picture, The Three Musketeers. And you were among the international stars presented to the Queen Mother. And for the millions of fans who know you best as Dracula and as the star of horror movies, here was a new Christopher Lee on the screen.
I failed. What does occasion you?
If I blundered as you do, my head would fall.
I would say from a greater height than mine, Eminence.
You would?
The height of vaulting ambition.
You have none?
No.
Do you fear me, Rochefort?
Yes, I fear you, Eminence. I also hate you.
I love you, my son, even when you fail.
And that's you in the role of Rutherford. And with you there, across the great Charlton Heston. And from that star-studded cast, here tonight is another special pal of yours, Oliver Reed. Oliver, you played Mathis in that film, but it wasn't by any means the first time that you'd worked with Christopher.
No, it wasn't. I think Christopher really worked for us because in the old days when I first worked for Hammer, I used to sit outside an air terminal in Cromwell Road. he picked us up and he used to charge us 5 shillings each
to go down
to Hammer Studios.
It'd be much more now.
And 5 shillings back in an old white Mercedes and constantly sing, I'm a dear, a female dear. And then he used to knock us and say, of course, you know, dear boy, I want to be an opera singer.
Want to be? I had been. Thank you very much, Oliver Reed.
Cheers,
thank you. Well, now, Oliver's a chum from that picture, and from the other side of the Atlantic, if you look at that screen, the man that we saw with you a few moments ago, you'll see him again, Cardinal Richelieu, himself, Charlton Heston.
And hello, Christopher. I really hate not being here in person. This performance is on film, to my deep chagrin and disappointment. I look forward to coming to London for the premiere of Three Musketeers and also to staying over for this big night for you. Unhappily, I'm stuck here in California doing another film, but I remember with great pleasure the time we spent last summer shooting in Spain on Three Musketeers. Well, I did love working with you, Christopher, and I do hate not being there tonight. Good luck to you and everyone else. See you soon in another film, I hope.
Thank you, Charlton Heston. Well, that's Castro and Castro.
Great man, great actor.
I agree. That part you play marks a big departure from the spine chillers you've played in scores of films like The Curse of Frankenstein and roles like Fu Manchu, Rasputin the Mad Monk, and of course your most famous portrayal of all, Count Dracula himself. Off-screen, it's a very different story, as we can prove by meeting the ladies who star in your real life. And here they are, your wife, Gitta, your mother, Estelle, your sister, Sandra, and your 10-year-old daughter, Christina.
Always surrounded by women.
Yes. Now, Gita, after starring in so many horror pictures, is Christopher often picked out, you know, as the dreaded Count Dracula when you're out together?
Well, normally, yes. But there was one time, I remember, when we were at Disneyland. Remember that? And we were walking around with Robert Quarry, and nobody recognized him. And not at all. And then Christina got this Mickey Mouse hat. And Robert said to Christopher, I bet you dare not put that one on. I said, of course I do, and put it on. And he was carrying Christina's teddy bear anywhere. At that moment, everybody in Disneyland came up and said, oh, Mr. Lee, we love your films.
And I was wearing a hat with Christina written on it, carrying a teddy bear.
He was a beauty.
Tell me, does Christina, in fact, get to watch her dad playing in horror pictures?
No, not very often, but she did see Dracula the other night. And, you know, we were rather worried whether she would have some nightmares or bad dreams or what have you.
Christina, did you dream?
Yes, I dreamt about Don Newland.
That was a great night for the family, Christopher, when you took your place at the Royal Premier, but there was just one member of the family unable to watch that proud occasion because he was 6,000 miles away at his home in South Africa, but he's not there tonight. From Johannesburg, your younger brother, Nicholas. Nicholas, although you are now an executive with an electronics firm in South Africa, you're still able to follow your brother's film career.
Yes, I do. I followed him pretty well from the beginning, when by watching a film very, very carefully, called The Corridor of Mirrors, I got a fleeting glimpse of your backside.
Very, very good. Thank you, Nicholas Lee. Thank you.
Well, anyway, that's the family reunited, Christopher. So let's go back to where it all began in the Belgravia district of London. Your late father is an army officer, and you're christened Christopher Frank Carandini Lee. Appropriately enough, for a man who's to play so many aristocratic roles, you've connections with European nobility. Mrs. Rose, what was the connection with the Carandini family in Italy?
Well, I was born Carandini, you see, because my father was really an Englishman, but his father was a pure Italian. And that's the name, you see, that the family name is Carandini.
Well, now, Zandra, I believe that even as a very young boy, Christopher was showing an interest in dramatics.
He was showing an interest, but he was quite a little boy in those days, and I hate to say it, but I was much older. And so I was the boss, and I got all the good parts. In fact, I played a glamorous part of the Scarlet Pimpernel, and Christopher was the innkeeper's wife in the background, just spitting on the floor and saying, Sacre Zaristo, not yet.
Well, later, Christopher, you attend Summerfield School in Oxford, and here at Oxford you get the chance of some much better roles with the School Dramatic Society. It's at that school, where you're only 8 years old, that you make friends with a fellow pupil who's determined even then to go on the stage when he grows up. He's out in Hollywood now, and though he can't be here tonight, we asked him what he remembered of young Christopher Lee, and here's what he has to say. International star of films and television's The Avengers, Patrick McNee.
This is a picture here of Chris Lee. It was taken in 1930, and he was 8. We were at a preparatory school in England called Summerfield's Oxford, which had many distinctions, but one of his distinctions for us was that they did Shakespeare plays. I played Henry V when I was 8, and he played Cassius, and I played Brutus, I think, when we were 9. And I was always surprised that he became an actor. I always expected him to be a diplomat or something very distinguished. He's got that wonderful, marvelous voice and his very distinguished mien. And I think he's a very fine actor. I saw the Billy Wilder Sherlock Holmes, for instance. And his range, I would have said, we've all seen the most famous parts of his range, but I think he has an acting life beyond that, which is going to surprise and delight many people. It's marvelous for me to say hello. And very good luck and best wishes, Chris.
Thank you, Patrick McNee. Now, from Summerfield School, you go on to Wellington College, and with a picture of the future star of horror movies looking very clean-cut on holiday, age 16. And at that time, Christopher, I believe the family had a very different career in mind for you. I think Patrick McNee had guessed it, in fact.
Yes, I think I'd made an absolutely disastrous diplomat, in point of fact. I'm quite sure of it, in fact. Ask my family, or anybody who knows me, for that matter.
But instead, your family fortunes take a tumble, and you have to leave school after 8 years as a classic scholar and start looking around for a job. Now, with your background, it's not hard for you to get a job as something in the city, except that something is a messenger boy with a shipping line. Do you remember your starting salary?
Yes, it was £1 a week.
£1 a week. At those wages, the big treat of the week for you and your friends in the mailing department is a meal out in a certain restaurant in the city, and on paydays you go along there with your chums.
Not bad value in those days, was it, Christopher? 1 and 6 pence for a three-course lunch?
One of those same chums to meet you again for the first time in 35 years, John Lavelle. You made a baseline. Now, John, you were to stay on that company for 30 years to become a manager. Did you ever think that young Lee here would go on to become a famous name in pictures?
Well, I always thought he was destined for higher things.
Taller,
yes. Rather than just be a messenger boy in the city. But I expect you still remember the very cheap three-course lunches.
Slater, as a matter of fact, yes, in Leadenhall Street. I remember very well indeed.
That's it.
Yes, and I remember the stamps I licked too.
Yeah. Thank you, John Lavelle. Thank you. Now, first, a more great side to John the RAF, and with a fluent command of no fewer than 5 languages, it's no surprise that your first active service posting is as intelligence officer with 260 Fighter Squadron in the Western Desert. And though it's tough out there, it's not all work and no play. One day, stationed now in Tunis, you order your driver to take you by truck to Algiers to buy wine for the officer's mess. But rounding a corner in the Atlas Mountains, you find yourself looking straight down the barrel of a submachine gun. Your driver stops, turns, and addresses you, the senior officer on this mission, with these words.
Well,
What do we do there, cop?
That same driver to meet you again for the first time in 15 years. Ex, yes, aircraftsman Peter Sturgeon, better known to you as you said, taxi. Taxi, as he called you, in that tricky situation, what was Christopher's first command?
Well, he fingered his same costume as stars and said, taxi, as a senior officer in charge of this truck, I command you to drive straight on down the Tommy gun. Anyway, drive on we did. Round the corner, we come bang into an American roadblock. Now, the Yanks who owned to our address thought they'd captured three German prisoners.
Two, there were only two of us.
Three of us in that truck.
Well, we know it's true, Chris, because we have found prisoner number three from that skirmish, and he's here to meet you for the first time in 20 years, ex-flight lieutenant Bobby Brown.
Bem, vocês viram aí o encontro This Your Life do Christoph Lee com vários atores que são seus contemporâneos. O filme pode ser, vocês podem assistir o restante na internet. Além do Charleston Heston, que apareceu, tem Vincent Price, tem o Peter Cushing e o Oliver Reed, que apareceu também. Bem, agora vamos ver uma atuação sonora, ele cantando mais uma interpretação vocal que foi feita quando ele tinha 92 anos. Vamos lá. Ah, ao instante, maestro, como dizia o Flávio Cavalcante. Vamos lá?
Does a man have to fight all his life, only in death to take flight to the skies? Warmongers vie to take my throne, no respect is ever shown.
In borderland raids, they came in their hordes, ransacking villages, taking the spoils, with nothing to lose and possessions few. Bold, sturdy, fearless and cruel,
defiant of baptism on pain of death, tough measures call for me to be ruthless, to set an example to the rebels, draconian for their worship of devils.
For 1,000 men all dead in one day, they would not renounce their heathen ways. 30 years of campaigning consumed to subject those pagans to Christian rule.
Sun a burning of vermin,
river flowing red with the blood of 4,000 men that I did behead.
I shed blood of Saxon men, I shed the blood of the Saxon men,
I shed the blood of the Saxon men,
I shed the blood of the Saxon men,
I shed it at Verdun.
I shed the blood of the Saxon men, I shed the blood of 4,000 Saxon men, I shed blood of Saxon men, I shed the blood of the Saxon men,
I shed the blood of the Saxon men. As I toil to force others out of Frankish soil, and I return to learn that all is lost, yet my companions I trust the sword and the cross.
Converting entire tribes by the sword, in the name of Jesus Christo, our Lord. On that day in Verdun, no mercy given, victory for the chosen people.
Here go I, a
on the shoulders of a man who yearns to spend but 1 hour with wife and child to gaze upon faces innocent and mild.
12,000 men all dead in one day, they would not renounce their heathen ways. 30 years of campaigning consumed to subject those pagans to Christian rule.
Bem, vocês assistiram então mais uma atuação do grande ator Christopher Lee, que faleceu no domingo, dia 7, mas que só foi anunciada a morte ontem por sua viúva, através de uma reportagem do portal do jornal Telegraph, de Londres. Isso que vocês assistiram, ele gravou e fez esse clipe aos 92 anos, ou seja, no ano passado. E para terminar o programa de hoje, em homenagem ao ator e cantor, nós vamos assistir ele cantando o grande sucesso de Frank Sinatra, My Way, ao estilo heavy metal. É uma coisa fora do comum o que ele e seus parceiros musicais conseguiram nessa música consagrada. Vejam só, My Way, com Christopher Lee. We'll be right back.
share of losing. Now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing.
Bem, esse foi Christoph Lee, que gravou 4 álbuns e 3 EPs com músicas no gênero heavy metal. Um homem que, ao nos deixar, aos 93 anos, deixou uma bagagem de aficionados fãs e também a dignidade de trabalhar em 300 filmes, adquirir diversas faces. Se você estiver interessado em saber mais, entre na internet, porque os filmes de terror, ou filmes de aventuras, ou filmes de ação que o Christoph Lee fez, estão todos disponíveis, e também as músicas que ele gravou, inclusive My Way. Muito obrigado, Visão Plural volta na próxima semana, às 16 horas, se nenhuma assessoria de imprensa criar algum caso para nós. Muito obrigado e até a semana que vem.